Let's take a look at acid hydrations of alkynes. So with alkenes, we remember we made an alcohol, a Markovnikov alcohol with no chance of carbocation rearrangement. But here, because we have two pi bonds, double the reactivity, we're going to end up making a ketone. We also know that this reaction is slow for terminal alkynes. In fact, it's slow for internal. And so what we do is we use a mercury 2 plus catalyst, a mercury 2 catalyst, for terminal. Now, a lot of places say that it's optional for internal, but I'm going to go ahead and put it because it's going to help us. It's okay to use the catalyst, although some say it's not necessary for the internal alkyne with two R groups, one on each end with carbon groups versus a hydrogen here for the terminal. So what do we make? We make, for example one, we make a ketone. And if we make this a little interesting for the second, we could make this unsymmetrical so that we would end up with two possible ketone products in the second example for the internal. But with a terminal, there's only one possibility. Okay, let's look at the mechanism. And we'll look at the terminal. So our mercury catalyst is going to add simultaneously concerted as the pi bond, one of the pi bonds from the alkyne grabs the mercury, nucleophilic attack on the Lewis acid. And so we get our mercurinium, cyclic mercurinium catalyst here. And at this point, we can add a nucleophilic water molecule to the more substituted position, bigger delta plus than the less able to carry positive charge terminal carbon here. And so we attack here, kick up the mercury, and we have our water addition. Anytime you add a water, you have left over. Again, this is an anti-type addition, although it's going to end up not mattering here. So we end up having to do an acid-base reaction every time we have water. So there's plenty of water molecules that can accomplish this next deprotonation. And so here we are with our mercuric alcohol. And so we have to eliminate our mercury at some point here. And so what can we do? Well, the first thing we do is we tautomerize this to a ketone. And in acidic conditions like we are, we have to tautomerize in this fashion, invoking a hydronium ion. And so what do we end up with? We end up with a protonated ketone. With our mercury still sitting there, waiting to leave. After we tautomerize, we're ready to get rid of our mercury, so we dump the mercury electrons that are bonded to the carbon into a pi bond between carbon and carbon here, and then kick up the pi bond onto the oxygen, the existing pi bond, and we're going to make our enol. And so now we are ready to tautomerize again and form our ketone. And so we do this in acidic conditions, again invoking a hydronium, And the final deprotonation, using one of our billions and billions and trillions of solvent molecules, we finally arrive at our ketone.